Hi everyone, welcome to this getting started video on how to add the SyncFusion Angular tab component to an Angular app. Just imagine that you need to design a web page to show a lot of content in a compact space divided into categories. To design this scenario, you can make use of the Angular tab component. It comes with a rich set of features like different header styles, orientation modes, and nested tabs, as well as a scrollable or pop-up tab when there are more tab items. In this video, I am going to show you how to add the Angular tab component to an Angular project using the Angular CLI tool. To begin, let me show you the steps to create an Angular project using the Angular CLI tool. I will edit my code using Visual Studio Code. Finally, I will view the output on any of the supported browser. First, you need to install the Angular CLI in your machine using this command, npm install -g at angular/cli. As I have already installed Angular CLI in my machine, I am skipping this step here. Next, create a new Angular project using this command, ng new project name. I named my project Angular Tabs. This will create an Angular project along with its dependencies. Now, navigate to the project folder. To use the SyncFusion Angular Tabs, I need to install the SyncFusion Angular Navigations package and its dependencies using this command, npm install at syncfusion/ej2angularnavigations --save. Next, open this application in Visual Studio Code. Navigate to the app module file and import the tab module from the SyncFusion EJ2 Angular Navigations package. Register it within the imports array of the ng module section. Next, open the main TS file and import the register license method from the SyncFusion EJ2 base package. Then, register the SyncFusion Angular trial license key by using the register license method. The license key registration is required for SyncFusion Angular components starting with the 2022 Volume 1 release. After that, make changes in the app component HTML file by replacing its default content with the Angular tabs code. Then, I need to define the eTabItems tag, which accepts n number of eTabItem definitions. Here, I want to display information about two different programming languages, so let's define two eTabItem tags within this eTabItems tag. For these tabs, I plan to initialize the tab using a JSON items collection, so I open the app component TS file first and create an array of objects named tab header text with the field text. Then, I assign this array elements to the header property of those two newly created tab items. I am going to display content inside the tab, therefore, let me define string array tab content and set appropriate values within it. Next, I assign this string elements to the content property. To align the tab content, define the property CSS class with appropriate class to override a few CSS classes. Also, I need to define CSS for the tabs component, so let me import the material theme in the style.css file. Along with this, I define a few CSS styles for this tab content class. Now, run this example using the command ngserve. So here, you can see in the output page, the tab component shows two different tab items. If I would like to change the tab header position to display at the bottom, left, or right, then I use the property header placement. To demonstrate, I am going to display the tab header on the left, so I define header placement and set its value as left. In the output page now, the tab header items are on the left side of the tab. You can see that no style is applied to the tab headers by default. To apply a specific style, you can either set predefined or custom classes to the tab root element. The available predefined classes are efill, ebackground, and ebackground, eaccent. I am going to set a background color to the active tab header by assigning the predefined class efill to the CSS class property. And now, you can see the active tab header has a background color. So far, I have shown you how to initialize the tab using the JSON collection items, but now, let's see how to initialize the tab item using a template. First, I need to define another eTabItem tag. Then, I define two ng template tags with reference variable header text and content and add the appropriate header and content to it. For better clarity, I will set the header placement property value to top. Looking at the output page now, the tab component rendered with the three headers, HTML, Java, and JavaScript. To initialize the tab component, using HTML elements, first, I need to remove the existing tab items and add the HTML division elements with a class attribute. I make sure that the header section is enclosed in a wrapper element, using the etabHeader class, and the corresponding content is mapped with the eContent class. I then set the appropriate header text and content for these division elements. Looking at the output page now, the tab component displays with headers and content. If you display more tab items in the tab component, there is a chance that the tab header items will overflow the available space. In this scenario, you may need to specify the appropriate tab display mode. By default, when you add more tabs, the tab component makes the overflowing tab items scrollable. I first define the width property to show you how this default scrollable mode works. I define more division elements here and set the appropriate header and content to it. Now, when you look at the output page, the tab header items are displayed in a single line with horizontal scrolling enabled at both ends. If I want to display those overflowing tab items in a pop-up, then I need to define the property overflow mode and set its value to pop-up. You can see in the tab component, when I click the down arrow, the overflowing tab header items are moved to the pop-up container like this. In this video, we have seen how to create an Angular CLI project using Visual Studio Code and how to add a SyncFusion Angular Tabs component to it. We have seen how to change the tab header position as well as how to set styles to the active tab header. Finally, we have seen how to add content using a template. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description below. You can also check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire Angular suite, with the link in the description. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.